Good morning. I am Luisa López Sánchez. I work as radio pharmacist at Medical Imaging Laboratory at Hospital Gregorio Marañón in Madrid. I am going to talk about PET tracers based on gallium-68. Why gallium-68? Firstly, because it is produced from commercially available long safe life generator, making PET technique accessible to those centers that lack of cyclotron. Gallium labeling chemistry is straightforward and site-specific. Its nuclide characteristics provide high-quality imaging resolution and sensitivity. The unnecessary radiation dose to the patient and personnel is minimized. Moreover, repetitive examinations can be performed within the same day, what is really interesting when you are working on animal research. Finally, the majority of therapeutic radionuclides is also metals, so the development of new PET tracers based on gallium might allow for theragnostics development. In our lab, we have a 50 millicuries germanium gallium generator and a fast lab synthesizer. Besides, we have an Agilent HPLC equipment that we use for the determination of chemical and radiochemical purity of our compounds. In the room just close to the lab, we do have a super Argus CT where PET CT scans are made to our animals. Our work has been based on the labeling of different DOTA peptides. This kind of labeling, it is quite easy and it's based on chelation reactions. It only comprises 5 steps that are the ones that you can read on the screen. We have designed a quick, reproducible, and completely automatized synthesis process that is suitable for the synthesis of gallium DOTATOC, gallium DOTANOC, gallium DOTATATE, gallium A54, and gallium A67. These last two are under evaluation. Finally, I would like to conclude saying that we are open to collaborate with anybody who is interested in labeling any kind of molecule with gallium or with any other radioisotope non-cyclotron-based. We would like to get in touch with people who have experience working with chelants different from DOTA or who work coupling gallium to small peptides and biomolecules. Finally, we are also interested in talk with people that have experience working with cell lines which express somatostatin receptors and are different from AR42G cells. Here you can read our contact information. Thank you very much for your attention.